the final sprint to completing the low lake level pumping station at Lake Mead, crews are now energizing the underground pumps that will access water fed from intake number 3. The submersible pumps that have been installed so far are going through a series of rigorous tests to ensure they're capable of pumping up to 900 million gallons of water a day to SNWA's 2 water treatment facilities. Peter, what exactly are we testing on these pumps?
The contractor is performing a 2-hour performance test to ensure that the pumps were installed properly and that they're operating similar to their characteristics when they were factory tested. The contractor has currently installed 30 of the 34 total pumps, and they've tested 20 of the pumping units. They plan to test the remaining pumps over the next several months, and later this year the contractor will perform a more extended testing of each of the pumping units and will be pumping water to the treatment plants to ensure the compatibility for delivery.
Pumping water from the nation's largest man-made lake is an enormous effort. Just how big and powerful are these pumps?
These pumps are the largest in the world in terms of lift and total flow. Each of the pumps can push 30 million gallons of water per day, lifting anywhere between 435 feet to 695 feet above ground. In total, this facility can move 900 million gallons per day of water to our treatment plant, lifting it up from 500 feet below ground to feed water to our community.
The $650 million pumping station will allow the Water Authority to keep drawing from the bottom of Lake Mead, even if the water level drops to Deadpool, the point at which Hoover Dam can no longer release water downstream to Arizona, California, and Mexico. The pumping station is the final piece to the SNWA's response to the ongoing drought. Lake Mead's elevation has dropped more than 130 feet since 2000. In 2015, the Water Authority completed construction of the third intake, allowing the SNWA to draw water from the deepest depths of Lake Mead. When the low lake level pumping station is complete, the pumping station and the third intake will ensure continued access to the primary water source for the more than 2 million people who live and work in southern Nevada.
There are a lot of moving parts to build the pumping station, but in the end, it will be able to pump water from Lake Mead to the SNWA's water treatment facility.
Yeah, all of these elements are critical in getting the water from Lake Mead to our community. 600 million gallons of water from this pumping station will move to our Alfred Merritt Smith water treatment facility, which is located right here on the shores of Lake Mead. The other 300 million gallons of water will be pumped to our River Mountains water treatment facility located in East Henderson.
Not far from the submersible pumps, construction continues on an electrical substation that will eventually power the pump station and serve as a backup power source for Lake Mead's other 2 intake pumping facilities. The low lake level pumping station will be operated and monitored by personnel on site and remotely. It will connect to the SNWA's water control network, through which highly trained operators control the facilities necessary to deliver water to the valley. They monitor flows, water levels, system pressures, and water quality through the entire distribution system. Scheduled for completion in 2020, the pumping station will play a critical role in maintaining reliable water infrastructure that can meet our community's water needs well into the future.
This facility and the third intake which supplies it has been developed through innovative works from world leaders in construction, underground construction, and pumping units themselves. So it's been a partnership that's been successful to ensure water delivered to our valley.